Assalamu alaikum. Labas. Min ayat. Ayatu. La. La. Safi, Anas Meti Alice Morrison. I'm Alice Morrison, je suis une aventurier. Anna Mulamdama. Wa Anna Awashi, Mahim Mushi, Ham Mushi, Anna Hek Al Bahri. The subject today, why not? Elashla, Pukwa. And the Balek Asma Kumbili Glizi, why not?
Why not?
Why not?
Why not?
Why not?
Why not?
But be careful, because there is also, why not? Let me hear you. Why not?
Why not?
Why not?
Why not?
Now usually, why not is an answer to a question or to a request. So I have some requests for you. Please, everybody stand up. What for? Stand up. Why not? Please, shake the hand of the person. So, Marathon de Mar, Marathon de Sable. Here are some facts. I'm here to talk to you today about my adventure in Morocco, my first one, which was Marathon de Sable. Oh, la la. Toughest foot race on the earth. You attain your 15 kilometers, 250 kilometers, 6 marathons in 6 days. 1 marathon, 80 kilometers. The temperature, 50 degrees centigrade. You have to carry all your own food and equipment. And it's very, very expensive. Very, very expensive. So, when my friend, Charlie, said to me, Alice, Elashla, why don't you run the Marathon des Sables with me? You can do it. I should have said, yeah, come on. You madman! No! No! Instead, I said, why not? So, I said, why not? And I thought to myself, no problem, I am superwoman. I can do this. This was for about 5 seconds, and then I thought of all the why not? Number one, I'm too fat to run in the desert. Number two, I am not fit. Number three, very important, I hate running. I really hate running. So, these were the things that after the initial, yes, why not, it's a great idea, you think, now I have to do it. And what I want to talk to you really today is about how to make the why not disappear. So first of all, these were my problems when I looked at the Marathon des Sables. Number one, very expensive. So I found a way to pay for it over 3 years. I took credit. Too fat. Unfortunately true. I went on a diet. Not fit enough. I wasn't fit enough when I signed up to do this challenge. I trained. I ran. I did Pilates for my stomach. I lifted weights. I even did yoga in the hammam, in the sauna. All of this to get get fit enough to run. And it wasn't a joke, really. I got up 5 o'clock in the morning, I ran 20 miles in the rain or in the snow in my own country. I took it really seriously, and sometimes I failed. A week would go and I wouldn't run and I'd feel terrible, but I always started again. I also came to Morocco several times and hiked in the Atlas Mountains, and that was fantastic training. Carry-on food and equipment. So when you do the Marathon des Sables, you have to take some obligatory items. Safety items, water, food, sleeping bag, these things, and they check your sack. And if you don't have these items, they give you a penalty. In order to make your backpack as light as possible, I paid great attention to details. So, here is my toothbrush. This weighs 9 grams. So I cut it because I didn't need it for a week. Tiny, it weighs 5 grams. So what I did was, in order to help myself with equipment, I made everything as light as possible. I took it very seriously. I paid a lot of attention to the details. -50°C. Now, I cannot change the weather. It's impossible. I'm not God. But I was living in the UK, I was living in England, where it's very cold, it rains all the time, and we never have a temperature like this. So what did I do? I moved to Morocco. I'm a writer, I can write anywhere. So in January, I came to Morocco in order to get used to the sun. Sand. Okay, so all of you who have run in sand know how difficult it is. It's horrible. Again, what did I do? I practiced. I ran in the Agafé Desert, I went to Zagora, I ran in the dunes, I went to Mazuga, I ran in the dunes. I practiced and I overcame it so that I knew what was going to happen. 6 marathons in 6 days. Before I signed up, I had never run a marathon. To me, the thought of 43 kilometers was enormous. So I stopped worrying about it, I ran a marathon, I ran an ultra, I ran 50 kilometers, I ran 60 kilometers. And then I realized I could do it. 80 kilometers, the longest stage. In the Marathon des Sables, on the fourth day, you have to run 2 marathons at once. You start and you stop. So again, for me, I thought, oh, I can never do 80 kilometers. It's impossible. So I didn't. I ran, the furthest I ran was 60 kilometers, but that was enough to make me understand I could complete another 20. So again, it went away. So the last obstacle for me was that it's the toughest foot race on earth. So instead of thinking this as an obstacle, I decided it was an advantage. Because if I could run the toughest foot race on earth, I would be amazing. Yes, I love that. Wow. So I changed my thinking. So there you go. All the left, all the no, all the not, was gone. And I was standing at the start line with 1,200 people in the middle of the Sahara Desert. I was so excited. Can you imagine? With my backpack, my hat, my glasses. I was like, oh my God, this is amazing. For 1 year I've been planning this, I've been working for it, I've moved to Morocco, I changed my life. And here I was at the beginning. It was very, very difficult. Very, very difficult. So this is what faced us. Dunes, and then for me the worst thing was when it was flat, sand and salt, because the sun came down from above and then the heat came up from below. So it was really, really hot and long. So for me, these salt flats were the worst possible time that I had. And they tortured me. Then there were the hills. Ilesh, Ilesh. You come to a jebel and you think, I have to run. time in the juggle. But you have to do it, you have to finish, and you just try and take it in your stride and do it. And then there were the feet. Of course, running in the sand in the heat, your feet become very stressed. Bad things happen to your feet. But every night I would go to the doctor at the camp, and she would take her knife, and she would cut me. Oh, mesquite. It's not nice. So why do it? This is what we felt like when we got back to the tent. In our lovely family, you share a tent with seven people. So here were my people in my tent. Very exhausted. Very exhausted. And do you know what this is for? This guy here? Because when you're running, if you rub, they bleed. So he had to put tape on to stop his nipples from bleeding. So this is how he felt at the end of every day. So you could ask, not Elash La, but Elash, why do you do it? And here is the answer, because it's very important when you're talking about why not, to talk about why. You feel like a champion. Anna Barton! Wow! Anna Barton alone! You are alone in nature very often for a long time, hours and hours in the desert. It is so beautiful and so quiet. It makes you feel at one with the earth, with Mother Earth. You find friends. This guy, this was on the 80 kilometer stage. He was also from Scotland, my country. We went together all through the night and into the dawn. 21 hours it took us, and we were together. I never met him before, but by the end, he was like my brother. And then really the last thing I would say to you is when you do an adventure like this, you are truly alive. We only live once. And when you do this, you live to the maximum. The maximum. This was when I had just finished. I had got my medal. And I can honestly say to you that finishing that race made me believe that I can do anything. Anything. It gave me belief in myself, which allows me to help other people, be generous, and share things with other people because I'm not worried about myself anymore. I know I can do things, so now I can focus outwardly. And I think this is a very important thing about saying, Elashla, why not? Because it gives you strength in yourself, it makes you believe in yourself, and then you can put things out. You don't have to look in, you can go out. So, what I'm trying to say to you is, when you get a challenge, make sure you think about the why not. So that you can say, why not? And then you, too, can become Superman. And now I hope you're going to join me because I'm going to take off.